Hello, I'm Corey Clothier. I'm the founder and director of Stantec's GenAV. So GenerationAV is part of the smart mobility team, and we focus on all things autonomous mobility. So today I'm having a conversation that's going to be extremely interesting with Julian Turner, the CEO of Westfield.
Hi, Corey. So as you all know, my name is Julian Turner, and I'm the Chief Executive of Westfield Technology Group. And we've been involved, obviously, in the manufacture of both cars and now pods for many years. We've sold over 20,000 vehicles all over the world. We've been working very closely with London Heathrow Airport, and then have developed this technology to now be replicated throughout the world.
I met you or became aware of you through the work that you were doing at Heathrow. Can you give us a little bit of that?
The Heathrow pod system is obviously one of the only complete fleet systems that's been in operation now for many years. It's completed nearly 7 million kilometres and taken nearly 4.5 million commercially paying passengers. And that's taking people from a car park through to Terminal 5 departures doorway. Taking about 20 minutes out of the journey if it'd been taken by bus, an enormous amount of carbon emissions that has been reduced because of that. But also, most importantly, it's taken 50,000 bus journeys off the road every year.
As you know, I was helping the UK and Greenwich with the early gateway project, which that was another one of your pilots, where you actually took the pods and you took them off the track and you were piloting them in kind of a campus environment. I see your expansion, I see your growth in the PRT world and where you're moving to other airports, but I also know that you're taking your pods off track. So I'd love to hear about your strategy there, what's changed in the technology.
Yeah, I think the most important thing is to remember that what we've done is we've taken a platform that's already done millions of kilometers of testing. So actually, that I think that's really important. So when we're putting this vehicle out in a more open environment, actually, the system's already proven itself extremely well, albeit in a semi-controlled environment. So that's really important from a technology perspective, but also to give it credibility. So when we did do the Greenwich project, it was the first time a fleet of these vehicles had been operating on a shared sort of pathway. There was a cycle path, footpath that was being shared, linking up a hotel, the cable car, through all the way to John Harrison Way, where people lived. So there were vehicles that were moving around, but again, I'd class that as a semi-controlled environment rather than anything else. So there obviously were people on scooters, there were children around, there were skateboarders, people jogging, walking, lots of cyclists. So it's a really good introduction into having a fleet operating in that open environment.
Great. Any anomalies or anything that was surprising in those operations? Something that you learned that you really didn't know you were going to learn?
So what we found is a lot of people didn't trust the technology. But I think once people had been on the vehicle, that trust had turned 180 degrees and they thoroughly believed in it. But what gave them confidence, obviously, was our link back to Heathrow, where these have been in commercial operation. So I think getting that message out there that these vehicles are already in operation gave people, you know, the confidence to then use the vehicles and get on them and experience it.
Yeah, tell me what's next for the pods.
So there's a lot more being done with the pods now. So obviously they're moving people. We're moving logistics around now. So hospitals, as well as goods for some business parks, as well as shopping for some of the, you know, groceries. So there's a lot more coming out of them, but we're also using that as a platform now that we can take across to pretty much any type of application. So we've put an autonomous road sweeper now on the pod. We're looking at putting a gritting system on the pod. So I think that technology has proven itself so well that we can now apply that across to other vehicles or other use cases, let's say. I think if we can create that controlled environments, we'll accelerate that deployment a lot better.
What do you see happening in the marketplace next 3, 5, 10 years?
So I think there's going to be controlled environments rolled out over the next couple of years. So a controlled environment could be, you know, airports, industrial parks, business parks. So I think that's where we're going to see a lot of this. We've been operating in shopping centres, the UNESCO World Heritage sites. We've got pods operating there, finance districts. So I think there's going to be a really good concentration and rollout in these areas, which are of fleets of vehicles. That's what we want to see. And then I think, you know, sort of within 5 years, we may see villages actually saying, look, let's stop cars coming in. Let's have a car park away from the village and then have a pod system servicing that operation. But in the UK, there's a big opportunity with some 57 disused railways that we can put this system in immediately, and it creates a semi-controlled environment to link different towns, villages, and even cities together.
Julian, really curious, as communities start to look at autonomy, could you give them some advice on how they might be able to get started in an autonomous vehicle future?
I think you need to create a clear vision of what you would like to do, and then find a provider that can fit to help you achieve that. Because what I think is going to be even more important in the future is having a one-stop shop solution. So not just, I need to buy these vehicles, it's what about solar power? What about communication technology? What about having a system that will help me communicate with all these different micro-mobility solutions and integration with some of the buses or larger vehicles that are around the site? And I think that's important that you look have a totally holistic view.
Excellent. We are singing the same song, my friend.
Yeah.